Born out of necessity, Borough Memorial Hospital served as a lifeline for African Americans during segregation. For some, it's a symbol of struggle and success, as well as progress and change. Today, we take a look back at how the hospital started and its positive impact on the community.
Borough Memorial was the first hospital in Southwest Virginia designed specifically to meet the medical needs of African Americans.
Well, I knew Ms. Sly and I knew Kim Clater, and this was Ms. Stewart, and I was Ms. Smith.
Joyce Bolden was born at the hospital and remembers it being the only place to go for quality health care.
For a segregated community, in a lot of ways, it was your lifeline.
Segregation served as a catalyst to open the medical facility. As the story goes, Dr. Isaac Burrell, a prominent African-American physician, developed severe gallstone problems. He couldn't seek treatment at Roanoke's white hospitals. Instead, he was forced to go to Freedman's in Washington, D.C., where he later died.
Through his death, the other doctors around here decided that we really did need a hospital for African Americans.
Borough Memorial started as a 10-bed facility, and by the mid-50s, it moved to a larger location that many now recognize as the place that provided medical care, jobs, and training to the community.
Borough Memorial Hospital remained a prominent African-American institution until the 1965 Civil Rights Act mandated the desegregation of hospitals. And when true integration came about and African-Americans could go to other hospitals in the city, the number of patients here at Borough dropped.
For the past year, we've been operating on the lowered census in general.
In the summer of 1968, Dr. F.W. Clater talked with WSLS reporters about the state of Borough. He said the decline in patients was partly due to integration, as well as the hospital's label as a black facility.
And instead of the community looking upon it as a Negro hospital, to look upon it as a community hospital for all of the people.
The hospital was so strongly identified as a Negro or African-American hospital that the larger community didn't feel comfortable coming there.
Dr. Conrad Clater is among three generations of Roanoke doctors. His grandfather, J.B., helped establish Borough. Like his ancestors, he shares a passion for helping others, regardless of race.
They were looking to be treated as equal. And I think that is something that, you know, kind of transcends the generations to today, is looking for that equality.
Clater believes progress has been made since the days of segregation. He says those who practiced before him would be proud to see that doctors are now recognized more for the quality of their work, not the color of their skin.
The patient population now is very diverse, that people come to you because they hear you're good and they want you to treat them.
Today, the historic hospital houses Blue Ridge Behavioral Health Care. While the name on the front remains the same, services and patient population has changed. But these pictures and stories on the walls serve as reminders of the sacrifices made, lives saved, and the significant role African Americans as well as Borough Hospital played.